The views and opinions of the hosts and guests are their own and do not necessarily reflect the position of the management and staff of Guardian Network.
The Revolution with Juan McCartney is brought to you in part by Burger King, Fidelity Bank, TF Express Delivery, Bronze Electrical Motors, Commonwealth Bank, Bahamas Bus and Truck Company Limited, J.S. Johnson, Wendy's, and L.A. Impact Windows and Doors.
All right, so you got to cue me, right? You got to let me know we live, let me know we hot. All right, good afternoon. Welcome to the Revolution here on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. My name's Juan McCartney. So good to have you with us. Before we get started, let me say COVID ambassador vehicle number 8. You straight up recklessly cut me off on Shirley Street when you were coming out at a Harbor Bay shopping center today, and you're wrong for that. And you cause me slam brakes, and you can't be riding around trying to enforce no law if you ain't gonna follow the law, all right? COVID ambassador vehicle number 8, with your green flashy light on top of your car, you drive terribly, all right? You a police officer, you and other officer in the front seat. You should know how to drive, how the traffic laws work. You can't come telling me about the protocol for COVID. I see you coming in the gym. You all sanitizing? You all okay. You can't drive, though. You don't know how to drive, but you're going to instruct me on COVID protocols. Anyway, all right. I don't have a particular agenda today or a line of topic of discussion, so we're just going to do more of an open line thing. You can call me if you have any concerns. If you're dealing with some sort of issue that requires a catharsis on air that facilitates the easement of a burden on your soul, you don't have to call me, right? You can seek to speak to your spiritual advisor or your significant other or just a stranger, perhaps, might care. I don't care. Okay? So if you have something of significance that's a topical issue that's not intensely personal to you, right? Feel free and call me and we'll speak about it. All right? 323-6232, 325-4316, and 325-4259. All right, we're dealing with the vaccine rollout first and foremost, okay? So now I see Dr. Dwayne Sands is taking the AstraZeneca vaccine today. Oh, the text line is 422-4796. 422-4796. So Dr. Dwayne Sands took the AstraZeneca vaccine today. I saw Dr. Darius Bain, who's one of my doctors. He took the AstraZeneca vaccine yesterday. I'm not going to lie to you. If Darius takes it, I'm leaning toward taking it. I'm going to wait. I'm going to see what happens, right? After the second dose. The 10 weeks from now. If the second dose don't take you out, Darius, I'm coming to see you, right? Or where I go? Glastonbury? I can't go yet. I guess I got to wait anyway. Right? If you're 65 and over, you could get it. If you're parliamentarian, 65 and over, you could get it without a point. But why 65? Why all the parliamentarians can't get it? Right? They all be jam up in the house with each other. Go get the vaccine, and then you ain't got to wear no mask. Half of y'all don't wear it properly anyway. It ain't going to be no problem. Right? So Ed Field says they got the capacity for 2,500 vaccine jabs a day. Good, because you had me concerned, because I was worried. Right? So because the private sector ain't involved, that still worries me. And PMH said it did 80 the other day, and they have the capacity to 120 the other day. So it's going to take y'all about 8-9 years, right, to vaccinate everyone to get to herd immunity. If you're vaccinating 120 people a day, you need to be vaccinating like 2,000 a day. Well, that field said 2,500. So if you're vaccinating 2,500 a day in about 20 weeks, you could probably have vaccinated, easily 100,000 people, right? But 20 weeks seems like too long. So I think you got to expand it even further. I think after you get your vaccines in country, then you allow the private sector to start doing it too. You know what I mean? And then you go, holla at the U.S. since they're giving vaccine to Mexico and Canada. Because what's crazy about the U.S. is they haven't approved AstraZeneca for emergency use. But they have millions of doses of it just sitting there in freezers. But the FDA hasn't yet approved it. But it's approved in Canada, approved in Mexico. The WHO approved it. The EU has approved it. Britain has approved it. So they really don't need it. So just sell it to us, right? Let us have it. Because they already vaccinated, I believe, 100 million people or something like this in the United States with the first dose of the vaccine. Good afternoon. Welcome to the revolution.
Good afternoon, Juan.
Hey, good afternoon.
Yeah, I know you have an open line form. Mm-hmm. Well, last week you was talking about the construction of airports. I tried to get in, but I was unfortunate at that time. What I would like to see happen in terms of the Luther is that airport in Governor's Harbor, mm-hmm. That itself can be extended. Of course, you know the geographic layout of Luther is the sea to sea is so close, so mm-hmm. you don't have that much room for a big expansion.
Right.
Now, what can happen in Saudi Luther, which is Roxong International Airport, that mm-hmm. need to be transformed. You need a new terminal with the state-of-the-art radar system, and then you can insert an additional two runways, upgrade mm-hmm. the present one to make sure it's in the best state that it should be in for safety reasons. And I don't see where you really need to do much about that airport at the extreme north, because literally you have all kind of incoming traffic there. You got about 5 or 6 different sea vessels. In addition to that, like I said, that airport could be used. It could be probably even owned by a private company. I don't care about that. Like that, I mean, it still can be operational, but I don't see where no bunch of money need to be invested in that one. But the hub should be Roxong International, because once you can put in the proper clearance, then you can have flights when it's available coming directly from Europe and other parts of the world, and they can get the pre-clearance right there in Roxong. You can have that kind of facility, and that will transform the entire Lucha with Jack's Bay coming on stream and the Cotton Bay Foundation, which has been non-existent for years. There's so many things can happen. But, of course, this take a vision. And this is my vision for Luther as an Lutheran. That's what I would like to see happen. We get the proper airlift, then we can look at the seaport. Some of them need to be upgraded as well. Mm-hmm. The Roxong docking facility need to be upgraded tremendously, then enable us to accommodate more vessels. And, of course, we can look at KB Lucha down the road, because, you know, that can be a whole new brand city.
Right,
and
now,
so that is what I would like to see happen for Lucha. So, sorry, Lucha, if you have any MP who don't have this vision, tell them get away from your door. That's what I would like to see happen in Lucha. Thank you.
Okay, good. But now we dropping 65 million. Well, when I say we, we're dropping 18 million. And the rest is coming from the finance group. We're already dropping. So we're putting $65 million into the North Eleuthera Airport. All right. Now, I'm from Eleuthera, right? My family is from Eleuthera. And I'm going to have to say that we're going to have to circle back to South Eleuthera in another couple of years. All right. So I agree with you with the docking facility. We could look at that. But in terms of a major investment in an airport, we're already doing that in North Eleuthera, and I do feel you. Eleuthera is very long, but I don't know that we continue that spend and focus on Eleuthera. Eleuthera is getting looked after in terms of major developments. We got Jack's Bay going there. We got the new airport going there. And we're also getting Disney has the fancy cruise port issue at Lighthouse Point. And I think that the docking facility would help, particularly with the Princess Cruise Line, I believe it is, that comes there in central Eleuthera. All right? That's just me. Says, Juan, my fiance and her coworkers never listened to your show before. I told her about your show, so she decided to listen today. She just called me and told me, I told her your show starts at 12. I told her you're a Bahamian, so you're always fashionably late, so keep the radio on. You should be to work soon and start the show. Well, it's 12:15, because we have the news, and then we have commercials, then we have other promos, and so I just said, let's just do 12:15. He says, hey, Juan, you see where Senator Darkwing Duck said he'll be a cabinet minister when the FNM wins? I don't take anything he says seriously or want to spend any time talking about him. It will only yuck up my vexation because he's useless. Good day, sir. Can private doctors or doctors' hospital bring in private vaccine for patients who wish other vaccine beside what the Bahamas government brings in for citizens? As it stands, I do not think they can. I know doctors who've said that they have access to the vaccine, and they have not been allowed to bring it in through the... They said that they're not allowed to even clear it. All right? So, and to me, that doesn't make sense. Now, if that's something... If they're doing that because they want to say that, well, look, we did the vaccine rollout, and we get the props, and it's politically motivated, then I think that's a bad idea. If there's some other concern, then let me know, because I don't understand how private doctors can bring in vaccines for other diseases, but are somehow not allowed to bring in vaccines for COVID-19. Now, don't get me wrong. They're not incredibly easy to source, but we do have doctors who have connections and medical institutions that have connections that you may not see in the Ministry of Health, right? So, and you want options as well. So the private sector may be able to source Moderna, may be able to source Pfizer, may be able to source Novavax, Johnson & Johnson, although I see that COVAX says that they're going to be providing Johnson & Johnson around July. So we'll be interested to see how that goes as well. But I fully think that the private sector needs to get involved with the vaccination effort just to get it done as fast as possible, because you can't tell me that they can vaccinate for everything else but can't vaccinate for COVID-19. You're just putting a jab in an arm. You know what I'm saying? How do you square telling doctors and pharmaceutical companies that they can import morphine, but and these very heavy anesthetics, right? Demerol, ever had that? Demerol, yeah. Ask for it by name, yes. Demerol, you have the best sleep of your life. All right. And you wake up feeling so good, you'll be like, oh, Demerol. I don't see how you could let them bring that stuff in, right? And stuff that'll take a horse out, but you won't let them bring in a COVID-19 vaccine. It doesn't make sense to me at all. Good afternoon. Welcome to the revolution.
Hello.
Hello. Good afternoon.
A pleasant good afternoon, Mr. McCartney.
All right.
You remember that medication what they say Prince took on Michael Jackson took?
Yeah, I don't know what that was called.
Photo of something. One time, I told a guy when I was working at Patelco, this doctor, this African doctor came in.
Mm-hmm.
And I was telling some issue, some bad toothache or something at that time. And I didn't know that is what that guy had prescribed to me until I went to Dr. Lewis one time to go deal with this crown or inlay he was doing. And I showed him this pill. He said, "Fuck, where you got these from?" I told him this doctor prescribed this to me, a customer at Batelco. He grabbed those pills, you know, he poured them right down in the toilet bowl right away. He said, "Fuck, you know, this man was trying to kill you or something." I didn't know I was taking it till I heard Michael Jackson took the bullet test.
Propofol, that's what someone said.
Propofol. I was taking them like one a night. And I could see, you talk about having a nice sleep, I could see why Michael Jackson said, "Give me some more."
Just knock you straight out.
They put you straight. You go so close to heaven.
How you wake
you
up?
Wouldn't know. But you know what I really call the action? I asked you this before. Mm. I would like you to investigate for me. Why is the Fort Charlotte area, the big park down, I call it downstairs.
Oh, yeah, you did ask me about this before, yeah.
Yeah. But the one up top, maybe up by Dean's Lane. You know that one up there?
Yeah, I know.
Where the straw vendors used to be?
I gotcha.
They have that block dog. Okay, I'm saying this for a reason. I have two big dogs, and sometimes I want to take them out to exercise. Mm-hmm. Most of the other public parks have children riding around bicycle, people doing their jogging and their walking, and people in the area. And you want to let these dogs, you know, do the little running, but I can't do that down there where them people is. And the people up there, the second I went and asked them, why is it closed? And they can't give me a reason. Why is the little small park closed, but the big park wide open to the public?
Well, I'm going to ask Shannon Don Cartwright about
that. That don't make no sense to me. Have a good day.
All right, my brother. I'll see if I can get hold of Cartwright and ask him why it's closed. The what? Oh, the entire fort's closed. They don't want traffic there. Okay. It's just because the fort's closed. The fort itself is closed. Good afternoon. Welcome to the revolution. Hello. Good afternoon.
Hello, Mr. McCartney.
How's it going?
How are you, sir?
I'm great. How are you doing?
You all right?
Yes.
Listen, Mr. McCartney.
Mm-hmm.
I want to say something concerning this is because vaccine. Listen, our government knows that they were going to receive this Zika vaccine, right?
Mm-hmm. AstraZeneca.
Why they didn't let the Bahamian people know they was going to get this vaccine so they could educate the people more on this vaccine?
But I've known for a couple of months now they were getting this. You didn't hear that?
No, but hold on. We didn't know we was going to get this type from
we
India.
Did.
Hold on. We didn't know we was going to get this from India.
The
now,
Indian one, okay.
Right. Every day you cut on your TV on United States News 7, CNN, they talk about this vaccine,
mm-hmm.
blood clots, all kind of different things.
Yeah.
That's making you afraid not to take it.
That's correct. Yeah.
That's real. That's realistic.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Now, our government knew this was coming to the Bahamas. I think what they should have done was educate, have this forum and educating the people. Okay, now, if you take it, you'll have some little backlashes. People are afraid now, blood clots. So
yep.
We didn't listen to what the United States have already said about this.
Yeah, well, so, they do need broader public education because the...
Right, they should have educated the Bahamian people on this.
Yeah, there was some, but they didn't have a lot. Because you'd recall when I had the doctor, various doctors on my show talking about vaccination programs, they specifically did not want to talk about COVID-19, which I found strange. It's a good opportunity to talk about the vaccines and the efficacy mm-hmm. of them and the safety of them, but they didn't take that opportunity. Mm-hmm. Now they're out here doing it, but it still needs to be broader public education.
Right. They should have had their PR. They should have had the nurses, especially they are the ones who's going to go out and give this vaccine. You know, doctors are not going to don't give vaccine, you know.
Right.
Only the nurses. So what they should have done, and every constituency in this Bahamas, see, you got to be afraid. See, people got to understand, when you need people, you can't do bad things to people if you know you need them.
Yeah, they won't communicate with the nurses.
Ah, okay.
That's
now we need the nurse system to work along to be able to give this vaccine out to the Bahamian people. And I'm saying this to say, the government notice was coming. The government should have got the nurses and every constituency in this Bahamas had a forum and every school in this Bahamas and educated the Bahamian on this same vaccine. The Bahamian people are afraid now because of what we heard. So you can't change our mind right now to talk about, oh, it don't go like that because every news station we go on, they are talking about this, blood clots, this, the other thing.
Yeah. But, I mean, they've come out. Thanks for calling. They've come out, and they've had new information just recently, just over the past 36 hours, talking about the blood clot issue, et cetera. Agreed, there needs to be better public education. I'm going to agree with you on that. It says, please call out government vehicle CM17. Tell them they need to learn how a roundabout works. You said that, I think, yesterday. This says, Juan, you didn't read my text. Yesterday, I want the sidewalk daddy to go back. Desmond Bannister, Minister of Work, sidewalk daddy. Jesus. It's good afternoon. Welcome to the revolution. Good afternoon. Are you there?
Hello.
Hi, good afternoon.
Juan, how are you?
I'm well. How are you?
Okay, I'm doing just great, my darling.
Excellent.
I started you to say, Bannister's also to him in the government needs to, and government needs to. Whenever we want to get any other information, we use this smartphone and Google Earth.
Right.
Also, many times something come up, right? Mm-hmm. And I know this is a great decision to have, right? But why is it that if we want to study or know more about this vaccination, why we can't just go online and find this information?
Why can.
The government always, the government does, the government
does. Now, the government does need to do it, though. If the government's given it to you, the government should explain to you that it's safe, right?
Yeah, but look how long we were talking about it coming and coming and being prepared for it. Now that it's here, right? Instead of we just talking about the government needs to do this and the government needs to do that, we can learn more about it, embrace it, and move forward from that.
Yeah, we can learn about it ourselves, certainly.
Yeah.
That's what I've done. But I don't think it's unfair to ask the government to have broader public education. You know what I mean?
I mean, he could do so, but not so much as people saying taking it unless the government explains to them.
Really? I don't know about that now. If you the government, you telling me to this vaccine, you need to explain to me what the deal is. Yes?
Well, I mean, for some person, but I mean, everybody just, you know.
I hear you. Some people are making it political, but I think some people genuinely are misinformed and need better education.
That is wrong.
Yeah.
And don't crucify me because it's just my opinion.
I'm not going to crucify you. I hear you. That's your opinion, and that's fine. I just think that the government has a duty of care to explain to people what it is that they're injecting them with. I don't think that's a stretch. That's just me. Good day, McCartney. Could you please find out if someone has died from the experimental vaccine AstraZeneca and can be proven, will the insurance company pay the life insurance to the family or even banks what is due? Thank you. I don't know, man. That's pretty broad there. I'm sure you'd have to look at your specific policy and see. I couldn't tell you, so I don't know. I mean, we could look at insurance professionals. It's not a bad question, but I couldn't really tell you at this time. This says, great show as usual. Juan, question, me and my fiance are going to Luthra. We're good to go for food and a good hotel. And where to go? Are you asking where to go for good food and a good hotel? And where to go for entertainment? And also, when I duck her to go see some mango skin gals, text me regarding this one. Because I hear some nice guys. Yeah, beautiful women on Luthra. Nah. Let me know where you're going. You go Top and Bay. I'll send you my cousin Kirk down there. He'll straighten you out, right? Nah. Gird yourself if you're going Top and Bay, right? So because their flex different from the Nassau flex if you go to Attitabut, right? So they don't stop. Okay. It says Demerol equals Bacardi 8. Yeah. That was, you just drift off, bruh. Good afternoon. Welcome to the revolution. Hello. Good afternoon.
Hey, Juan.
Hey, how's it going?
Good afternoon to you. How are you?
I'm good.
Good. Very quickly, yeah. Juan, the vaccine, you know, when one sits down, we have to realize that one size does not fit all. I think the main thing any responsible government should do before administering any sort of medication, you should know the health condition of the person that you're about to inject.
Yeah, absolutely.
With the medicine, because it may be.
Well, I don't know that that's fair on. I don't think that's fair on the government. If you're opting to take the vaccine, you should understand your health condition.
Well,
not the government.
Yeah, it goes both ways, Juan. It goes both ways. I think basically, I think one or two or the other, if my understanding is correct.
I think you're right in terms of if you have, hold on. Don't just keep talking.
Okay.
I think you're right in terms of if the government should ask you certain qualifying questions, such as, are you allergic to anything XYZ? Do you have XYZ condition like that? So I think that's fair, but I think in terms of you going to take the vaccine, you should speak with your doctor before that.
Yeah, and that's exactly where I'm going, because like I said, you could take something. This is why, you know, they are warnings for different medication. Hey, this the side effects is this. Or if you're taking this medication already, then you should not take this. But it's very incumbent that we know that each person, you know, one size, like I said, does not fit all. This person, you need to know their health condition before you inject them. And I'll close on this one point of one. I think with the, like, there is one, I don't know if it's Johnson & Johnson, if I'm sure, you know, not really sure of it, where perhaps it's a lower dose, that's why you have to take two instead of one, just one dose. That would be good as well if we can find research on that to find out what's really the ingredients in it. So we can help some persons who may have a strong allergic reaction to, let's say, the AstraZeneca brand. That's something that perhaps the government can allay a lot of the fears of the public if from the educational standpoint, if they are able to do that.
I agree. Thanks, Jeff. I agree. I agree that options would make the choice that much more palatable, right? So that's a good point. So Johnson & Johnson is just a single dose. AstraZeneca is two doses. Pfizer and Moderna are two doses. So I prefer to take the Johnson & Johnson one because it's a single dose, because they use the traditional methods of cultivating the vaccine. It is not as efficacious, they say, as the AstraZeneca, but AstraZeneca is not as efficacious as Pfizer and Moderna, but Johnson & Johnson, I believe, is somewhere upwards of 67% effective, and that's good enough for me, right? So that's much, much more effective than your average flu vaccine. Good afternoon. Welcome to the revolution. Hello, good afternoon. Nope, okay. It says, whatever time you start the show is the time it starts. It's well worth the wait. Why, thank you. LOL, hey Juan, what's the name of the vaccine? Kazika? I know, I think she just is mispronouncing it. Good day. Do you think it's about time that security officers get trained in carrying firearms? Yeah, I think that's a fair point. I think there's levels to security officers. So if you have a security officer who's trained in firearm use, pay them more. And a security officer who would have a firearm license, you'd pay them more. That would have to be structured properly in terms of the security company would have to have rigorous training, checking, et cetera, in order to make sure their security officers were issued firearms and where they would be doing that. So somewhere like a bank, for example, I could understand if it is your neighborhood liquor store, maybe not so much, although I do think store owners should be allowed to have firearms licenses. That would require training, vetting, etc. But I do think that the number of people who've been robbed, shot, killed by criminals who don't have any qualifying process but have easy, super easy access to firearms would demonstrate that it's about time that we let store owners, particularly if they work certain hours, carry firearms. This says, Michael took propofol. Sparky's confused. Propofol is a liquid that is administered by injection. This says, McCartney, if the U.S. doesn't approve AstraZeneca, will they allow their citizens to come here if we vaccinate with a non-approved vaccine? Yeah, they can't stop them. He can't stop you doing anything. I do think, and I'd have to game this out a bit more, but I do think that if you're a U.S. citizen and you're seeking to come to the Bahamas and you can show that you've been fully vaccinated, that they should waive the PCR test, right? You can still get the health visa, but if you could show proof of being properly vaccinated, they should waive the PCR test. That's my opinion. That I think would allow a lot more traffic to flow. You can do it. Thank me later. You don't have to credit me, right? So I often come up with these great ideas, and you guys tell me it doesn't make sense, and then the government goes, you see, McCartney would come and do it. All right. I said this a long time ago, but okay. This says, Juan, what kind of service are you providing? LOL, may have to change the topic of today's show. Seems interesting. Says one, Brave Davis and the PLP are playing politics with this vaccine. They spend more time criticizing than joining forces to help and promote just the facts in the vaccine in case they forget they're part of the government. I mean, I don't know. I heard that yesterday, too. And I mean, I see that Fred Mitchell took the vaccine yesterday when they offered it to parliamentarians 65 and over. So I don't see anyone from any political party. I'm sorry. Let me rephrase that. I don't see anyone from the PLP or the FNM saying don't take the vaccine. If you heard that, let me know, and I'll have to inquire what their rationale is behind that. I haven't seen anyone saying don't take it. They're not going to take it. What I've heard is them saying that they want the vaccination to ramp up. They want the vaccinations to get here more quickly. The doses to get here more quickly, and that's fair. I don't think that's unfair. If you playing politics to me, unless you nitpick in over garbage, right? Which I haven't heard that from Brave. You call Brave Davis in the PLP. I haven't heard that from Brave Davis or the chairman of the PLP, that nitpicking. But if you have, let me know. We're going to take a break. We'll be right back.
There's only one way to have a better morning. Start your mornings the best way with our 2 for $6 breakfast sandwiches at Wendy's. For a limited time, choose any two of your favorite breakfast sandwiches, including the fresh Kraken Sack Muffin, honey buttermilk chicken biscuit, double sausage muffin, or the sausage egg and cheese biscuit. Wash it all down with our cold brew shake or coffee. Better mornings always start at Wendy's. Wendy's, different inside and out. Excludes airport locations.
Hello, sir. Your credit card bill is due. Hello, sir. It's time for your monthly loan payment. Tired of creditors pounding at your door? Sign up for a debt consolidation loan from Fidelity Bank and consolidate your debt into one low monthly payment. What's more, you'll also earn interest on a built-in savings account. The pandemic has curbed many freedoms, but at Fidelity, our focus is to help regain your financial freedom. Visit a branch or speak to Fidelity Bank at 356-7764. COVID safety measures in place at all branches. Fidelity, we're good for you.
Tired of banks forcing you to use technology to bank the way they want you to? Your convenience is important. So no matter what your banking needs, Commonwealth Bank's friendly staff are always available in branch for that personal one-on-one service. But when you choose technology, our online and mobile banking app offers you state-of-the-art functionality. The choice is yours. Commonwealth Bank. Bank the way you want.
At Ron's Electric Motors, they repair and rewind all major brands of electric motors, including water pumps, generators, and generators back end, welding machines, electric lifts, air compressors, battery chargers, and more. They're equipped to handle up to 850 kilowatts and rewind up to 450 horsepower motors. They're conveniently located on the corner of Wolf and Clarence Roads and are open weekdays 8 a.m. to 5 p.m., Saturdays till noon. They offer 24 hours emergency assistance. You can reach them at 242-356-0249.
Everyone should experience a brand new car, but not everyone can afford one. Until now, Bahamas Bus and Truck has the answer. The stylish, spacious, feature-rich, yet affordable Mitsubishi Attrage. Priced at $21,900, including a three-year warranty, why not come and experience the value that Mitsubishi has built into the Attrage today? Bahamas Bus and Truck, the country's only authorized Mitsubishi dealer. Telephone 322-1722.
Always on the go? Missed the show? You can now listen to Guardian Radio talk shows anytime, anywhere on Spotify and YouTube by searching Guardian Radio 96.9 FM or by entering the name of your favorite show. You can also listen by logging on to guardiantalkradio.com and clicking on the podcast tab. Guardian Radio, continuing to provide you with fresh news and smart talk anywhere, anytime, all day.
Good afternoon, Bahamas. Welcome back to the revolution here on Guardian Radio. 96.9 FM. My name's Juan McCartney. So good to have you with us. Says, since we started the fantasy cabinet exercise, can we do one where Minnis loses his seat, but the FNM wins the election? I'm done with fantasy cabinets for now, but... Since we're trafficking in fantasy, you could have that scenario, but the likelihood of Minnis losing that seat is really, 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 really small. Good afternoon. Welcome to the revolution.
Good afternoon, Mr. McCartney. How are you, man?
Hey, I'm well. How's it going?
Good, too, as always, man. Listen, I looked at the video that... Senator Fred Mitchell, when he took the vaccine, which brings me to the point to why I made the statement I made about the prime minister, they showed clearly, you know, the full process of Senator Mitchell taking the vaccine.
Right.
With respect to the prime minister, the lady was blocking and she shows you the bottle with the vaccine, then she turns her back and like she's doing something else, and then she comes back with this needle, and then she blocks the needle. I think they gave the prime minister the complex, and that's just it. I don't think he took the vaccine. Now, to my second point, wanted to speak to, you know, the prime minister calling the PLP four final candidates contaminants. You know, he calls them contaminants, but when he sits in cabinet with his cabinet ministers who a judge condemned across the national podium and stuff, and, you know, with him sitting with a known criminal from the U.S., where he had this man sign somebody else's name, and I say he hadn't signed it because the way the prime minister was looking down, when you look at the camera, how he's looking at the corner of his eye at this man signing somebody else's name, like this man was coached to do that, you know, and everything. When you see the prime minister do stuff like that, what do you call that? If the PLP candidates who they have not been able to prove any guilt of any crime or anything, what do you call these people when you sit down and do the type of things that you do when you sit in your cabinet with ministers who the court has condemned? What do you call them when you are calling the PLP candidates contaminants? See, this is why I say the people of the Commonwealth of the Bahamas does not trust the prime minister. This vaccine thing has nothing to do with people taking vaccine. You know, it's a trust issue. People just don't trust the prime minister. So he's going to always have this issue with people and his vaccine. So, you know, me, I'm going to go to the U.S. and take it when I'm ready to take it. All right? I'm telling you straight out, I am going to take the vaccine, but I'm going to the U.S. I will not take one here because I personally don't trust the prime minister. Thank you.
But that doesn't make any sense. You just said you saw Fred Mitchell take it, but you're not going to take it? You're going to go to the U.S.? So Fred Mitchell trusts the vaccine, but you don't trust the vaccine here. I see. All right. Also, you know, what I would call the prime minister's issue with OBAN is just recklessness and not doing his due diligence. All right. They halted the deal. And here we are. Good afternoon. Welcome to the revolution. Hello. Good afternoon.
Hey, good afternoon, Juan. Hope all is well.
All is pretty good.
That was good. Hey, listen, I am kind of a little bit annoyed about these callers and stuff with regard to this vaccine.
Okay.
We got to start making this political. Vaccine is not a political issue.
Yeah, he's making it political, and which it doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, I don't understand. Why are they being political?
But they're being political beyond their own political parties. Like, they're saying stuff their own party's not saying.
Yeah, exactly. And so my thing is, what needs to happen is the facts on both sides just need to be placed on the table. People need to look at the facts and make their own decisions.
Right.
But to come and muddy this thing up with political foolishness is just stupid.
Yeah.
We have a country to build, and we need to make sure that our country moves forward. And if we continue along this path, we're going to be stifled and going to put ourselves at risk.
Yep.
All right? Thanks, buddy.
All right. You know, I mean, go to the U.S. and take the vaccine if you'd like. That's fine. But there's no reason that, you know, you should just not take the vaccine because you didn't see the prime minister take it. It doesn't make sense. Good day, Juan. Do you have to wear a mask when you're walking your dog? I saw your boy DeWitt on Harrow Road walking his dog with no mask. Yo, what? DeWitt, they watching you, buddy. You get like me now. You get on my level. They'll be watching me come out the store. So you're supposed to wear your mask when you walk your dog. If you're like jogging with your dog, you don't have to wear your mask. But you're supposed to wear your mask when you're walking your dog. Good afternoon. Welcome to the revolution.
Good afternoon. How's it going, bro?
I'm good, man. How's it doing? How's it going?
And what I think these callers are doing, right, besides the previous callers, they're trying to turn this vaccine issue into some kind of referendum.
I don't understand why. I don't get it.
I don't understand either, right? Their chairman has just recently took the vaccine. I don't know why they're still pushing this agenda.
It doesn't make any sense. And Brave David says he's going to go get vaccinated. So what's the point? I mean, you know, come on. Some things don't have to be about party. You know what I mean?
I agree. This is about country. It's about doing what we need to do to get this country back to where it's supposed to be. Right? And I think it's reckless. It's reckless to be feeding into these false narratives.
Because Minnis was sloppy with Oban, and you didn't see the label on the vial. No, you're going to leave the country to go take a different vaccine that your party chairman has already taken, your leader says he will take, that your party says there should be more of for more people to take.
And I'm level with you. Do we really think we are the people, right, which, like, for example, you think the nurse that took down vaccine would give the prime minister vaccine?
Does that make any sense? No, it does not make any sense. Period.
Thanks, bro.
Yeah, all right. It's, you know, you gotta sometimes pull yourself out of this fog of politics. So when you see the texter saying, well, the PLP is trying to make it political, that's what, I don't hear the PLP trying to make it political, but I see some PLP supporters making it political. And then they look at it and go, well, that's the PLP trying to make it political. Now, they might make it political at some point, but I don't see. This says, hi, Juan, I don't think it makes sense that they should have the RT-PCR tests. Because as experts have stated, being vaccinated does not prevent one from contracting COVID or spreading COVID. It does reduce the risk of transmission, they have found. In Israel, in Britain, in the United States, significantly reduces the risk of transmission, which they weren't sure about when they started doing it, but they have studies to show that it does. I watch Israel very closely, even though we don't have the Pfizer vaccine, because Israel is the fastest. They're the fastest to publish data on a widespread scale of the impacts of the vaccine. It says the only benefit the vaccine offers is that it reduces your chances of the virus killing you and your symptoms. Correct me if I'm wrong on this. Okay, well, I just corrected you. So in addition to reducing the chances of the virus killing you and the severity of your symptoms, they found that it now is reducing transmission significantly, sometimes up to 70%. Good afternoon. Welcome to the revolution.
Good afternoon, Juan. How are you today?
I'm pretty good. How's it going?
All right. Now that Bahamas is beginning to take this particular vaccine, would the curfew be now lifted?
Or is the virus
still coming out after 10 o'clock in the night?
Yeah, so the curfew should have been lifted long ago, and I'm glad you brought that up. I'm sorry, you finished your point. You had a point to make? I probably make it on the other side. Or were you just asking?
What I'm saying to you, I mean, it's kind of frustrating because I went to church service last night.
Yeah, it's mad.
Church came out like 9:20. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And to rush from East Street to get to Carmichael Road, that's a challenge, man.
No,
you understand what I'm saying to you?
Yep.
And some officers are not going to hear that you've been to church.
Well, listen.
You're supposed to be in at 10 o'clock.
The 10 o'clock curfew makes no sense.
That doesn't make any sense at all.
Zero.
Because my thing is, I thought as long as the virus, a vaccine process has begun, our curfew should start to be lifted, even if it goes to 11 or 12 o'clock, and then gradually lift from being curfew altogether.
Yeah, I think it should have lifted before the vaccine ever came.
I think it shouldn't have gone
past Christmas.
Yes, thank you, man.
Yeah, you're welcome. And we're going to talk about that on the other side. I know I said I didn't have a specific thing I wanted to talk about, but that I do want to talk about these emergency orders, right? So I only got a few seconds here. You see now where we have funerals can be allowed in churches, and weddings can now be held inside the religious facility with one-third of facility's capacity. See, my issue with the emergency order is this. You're far too comfortable with it at this point, right? These are decisions that should have been made based on specific metrics. So there's no specific metric that I can see that is different now than from what was happening earlier this year that you should not have allowed these things to happen. There's no specific metric I can see that means that these things could not have happened at the same time the churches were allowed to have services. And I try not to get too into it on the show because I do get emotional about it because I've lived it. But you got to start, and I'm going to talk more about it. You have to do these things based on science if you say that science informs them, because there's all that happened was you're campaigning now and you're allowing people to campaign and gather and people are going, well, what the hell? Why can't I bury my loved one as I want? And why can't I have the funeral in a church? Why can't I get married in a church with social distancing if they can have a wedding, if they can have a big ceremony or a convention or whatever? And now you're reacting to that, and it's not science. And this is why these emergency orders are dangerous when you hold on to them for too long. Stay tuned, we'll be right back.
Believe this? We are now the patrol queens of the neighborhood.
We now large and in charge. So we need to check out what's going on in everybody yard. What about that gun that we know that Junior and his homeboys just ran out? Can we report that too?
Of course we can.
But we could be in deep trouble if they find out.
We need to report what we see, Beulah. When you call Crime Stoppers, they just answer your call in Miami.
So then we can report everything? Guns? Where they hiding the drugs? Who shoot who? Who part of which gang? Or who disturbing the peace with the loud music and the motorcycle?
Then our neighborhood will be the best in the Bahamas, and everybody gonna want to come live here. And then our house price will go up, gal.
So what are we waiting on? What's the number?
If you see something, say something. Let us all pitch in and stop the crime before it's your time. Call 328-8477 from Nassau, or 242-300-8477 from the Family Islands, or text us through the Crack Crime Bahamas app. Stop the crime before it's your time.
In life, there are always challenges. Today, we find ourselves having to be more self-sufficient, socially aware, and technically savvy. At J.S. Johnson, we are committed to our customers by providing cost-effective insurance solutions. No matter what your insurance needs, we will always be here for you. Call 397-2100 or visit jsjohnson.com. J.S. Johnson Insurance Agents and Brokers, giving you peace of mind.
Welcome back to The Revolution here on Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. My name's Juan McCartney. So great to have you with us. Just briefly on these emergency orders. I'm going to say that I'm past the point of infuriation with them because we've turned a corner, right? So we're a little bit a ways away from Scroogeville at this point. All right, so we're kind of not exactly sure where we're going, but we're a bit of ways away from Scroogeville, but we're still kind of, you know. These emergency powers are far too serious to be taken casually. All right? So now that we are where we are, my recommendation to you would be, as the gentleman said, if you must have the emergency orders, if you must have them, I suggest at this point you review them. So, as the gentleman said, move the curfew from 10 p.m. to midnight to 4 a.m. on New Providence. If the curfew is in time, then move it, reduce it. Let's review some of the measures that we have in place and ease them if you must have the emergency powers. All right, so mask wearing, I'm fine with it. I've gotten used to mask wearing now. I could be a stormtrooper, no problem, right? The sanitizing, I don't have, well, I got a problem with all the sanitizing, but because, you know, I don't know, my hands now are all messed up, you know what I mean? They used to be all soft and, you know what I'm saying? Supple. So, now they're all craggy and, you know, cracked. And, so the sanitizing I got a problem with. The hand washing I got a problem with. Right? But a lot of this stuff is not necessary, such as the PCR test to go from island to island, such as the ban on indoor dining, such as the ban on all social gathering outside of weddings, funerals, and church services. I would suggest you review them. All right? I'm not going to flip out on you. I'm just making a suggestion that at this point, they warrant a review. They're valid until the end of May. We're due a review now, and I would suggest your review happen now before Easter. And after Easter, or before Easter, either way, we have some different things going on. All right? That's my suggestion. It says, blessings, Juan. I wonder, that's a long one, I'm going to get back to that one. McCartney, I'm taking the vaccine and I want my certificate to go with it. However, it won't be the AstraZeneca vaccine. I don't care how much they campaign and promote it, I'm taking another vaccine. Now, as it relates to this vaccine rollout, for safety and since the idea is to achieve said herd immunity, shouldn't they test people first to see if they have COVID-19 before they inject them? Also, if the aim is to achieve said herd immunity, shouldn't people be tested to see if they have already developed antibodies or antigens because they have already had COVID-19 and some overcame it? If they already have antibodies or antigens, they should already be immune to COVID-19. Hence, you don't need to vaccinate folks if they have already developed immunity to COVID-19 because after all, in the end, the whole idea is to achieve herd immunity. Think about it. Really think about it. There's some merit in what you're saying, but I think that the fact that you don't know how long that immunity would last from having COVID-19 and the fact that you don't know whether you can be reinfected with COVID-19, you should probably get the vaccine, I think. It says, don't kill my dream about Minnesota losing. Says, you dream on, brother. Dream. We all have dreams. We all have dreams, eh? Greetings, Juan. So let me get this right. The G5 wealthy countries halted use of the vaccine, and we third world foods are still taking this free vaccine. The international media started downplaying just how many deaths occurred as a result of this vaccine. 48 Laws of Power teaches that one must despise the free lunch. They've resumed administering it, so, and it's the only option we have. And we're not G5 countries. These same countries have oversubscribed the doses of the other vaccines to the point that we're not able to get them. Says, sorry, Juan, but I can't call the Oban signing recklessness on Minnesota's part. You know who name on the paper. If someone else show up, he should have run them and canceled the deal. Well, the deal was ultimately halted, you know. But he was suggesting that somehow Minnesota was colluding with Peter Krieger to pull some sham on the Bahamian people, and I wouldn't say that. It says, all of these all these vaccines are not safe. The world has become too political, especially the USA, the CDC, and the WHO. They tell you that children don't get the virus or spread COVID. Still, we as parents and adults are abusing these children with putting these face masks on children in school for 6 hours. Come on, man. Where are our brains at? And we as adults who aren't sick with COVID are wearing the same mask for days and weeks. We all need to be educated. You're not supposed to touch your mask after you put it on, and surgical masks are one use only. You make some good points, however. I don't agree with the point that you're saying about, well, the vaccine is a political thing and they're not safe. I don't agree with that. But I do agree that the children should not have to wear face masks in class. I agree with that point. But they seem to be managing with it so far. I would tend to agree with you that they've done it in other countries very much so, particularly in the young children. Without face masks, I think we could do that as well. He says, Juan, you're right. Bradley Kemp made no sense with that statement. Is that his name? His chairman, Fred Mitchell, took the vaccine, but he's traveling to the U.S. to get his. Politics is going to rip this country to pieces. They're trying to make this vaccine political. Well, let me say this, right? Political, whatever, anti-vaxxer, whatever. And I don't consider if you're reluctant to take it that you're an anti-vaxxer. I don't have that point of view. But you got to consider that if someone in your family is very vulnerable, because people have died, right? A lot of elderly people who are vulnerable. If they had the opportunity to take this vaccine rather than die, they should take it, right? Because COVID-19, while the recovery rate is very high, can kill you, particularly if you're older, especially if you're older, especially if you have comorbidities. So I feel your energy, a lot of you out here who are saying the vaccines aren't safe and all this. That's you can gamble with that, but there are people who the odds are against them, and if there's a tool here to help them, I suggest they talk to their doctor and then utilize that tool. This is J-Mac. I just took my almost 80-year-old parents to Loyola Hall to be vaccinated, and if there's something sinister about the vaccine, rest assured that a huge chunk of our white over 65 population will fall prey to it. They were present in incredibly large numbers being vaccinated. Just saying that for all the skeptics out there who are black and feel that the vaccine is here to wipe us out or harm us in some way. People are looking for the vaccine because they're scared of COVID-19. This says nothing will work for them. They've forsaken their own. They're gone. They will implode as the time draws to the big day. They've disrespected the Bahamian people, destroyed our businesses and families. McCartney, the minister of tourism, said on the news last night that people coming from Haiti was bringing the virus COVID-19 to the Bahamas. Is this true? He'd have to show me some data to support that. I don't understand why they put that big, long ban on Haiti. If that's the case, then the virus stopped coming from Haiti. Stop coming from the U.S.? Did the Haitians who came to the Bahamas legally through our ports not have to take RT-PCR test to qualify for the health visa? You got to use logic and sense when you're talking to me now. You can't just say stuff. And I go, oh, okay, well, because the Haitians was bringing the virus. Well, how do Haitians are able to circumvent your system? Right? Because they came here legally, yes? You issued them a health visa, yes? So if they were bringing the virus, then how would they get it? Someone's saying the station, they think the station's off air? No, we're not off air. Yeah, we're broadcasting. Good afternoon, welcome to the revolution. As far as I know, we're broadcasting.
Yes, good afternoon, Mr. McCartney.
Hey, my brother.
Yeah, you know, everything is all right. Those last three texts, I agree with the ones that you read just maybe before the last one. Those two texts about closing the businesses and the person having COVID-19, right? And so what happens is, I dare any because this came over across from a medical journalist, and I dare any journalist to read the viral letter that went viral from Dr. Gerd van den Bosch, right? And so he was basically explaining like what I was saying about the antibody-dependent enhancement and the viral immune escape, the innate immune response, and the adaptive immune response, which in the injection itself, the vaccination itself, produces an adaptive immune response, which produces specific antibodies to target a specific pathogen. So what he's saying with the innate immune response, which in possesses all of the neutrophils and all of the non-specific antibodies, right, they actually have a better, wider scope of response naturally because of they're able to handle the variants. Now, how I know what he's saying is true because I'm a reader. Now, remember when I told you, I just remember that antibodies mutate. Antibodies go to the germline centers, which would be the secondary lymphoid system, and it would be the bone marrow. They go there, and they mutate to become more affinitive to specific pathogens, antigens, immunogens, whatever. But the fact that you're calling and speaking the truth is a problem. Now, I dare anyone to read that viral letter out to the public that this guy is a pro-vaxxer because he worked for GlaxoSmithKline, right? Novo Radis, program research leader. He worked for the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation as a senior program official at Global Health. He worked for Univox, chief innovator of scientific officer. He also worked with Verico, where he was the director of adjuvants. So the fact that you have vaccination companies have a specific department for adjuvants, and shows you now that whenever any sensible person look back retrospectively at this data and information, they will see where they have gone wrong. Now,
yeah, I haven't read the letter, but I saw the video with him. But my question is this.
But Dr. McCarthy, what I'm saying is, along with other doctors, the fact that they're suppressing the information, you could be suppressing the truth. You know, as far as freedom of opinion, of expression, John Stuart Mill said, he said that the tyranny of the majority has gained complete control over the development of the individuals. When conformity becomes all-pervasive, social stagnation sets in. And I've listened to all of the people, various people calling. They have no idea about the immune system. That's why I always reading. And so what he's saying is, this is the same thing what I was saying is antibody-dependent enhancement and disease enhancement. And this is why I was telling you is the vaccination polyclonal or monoclonal. And so if you have the specific antibodies, they are more, let's put it this way, they more active than the innate. So the innate would be more passive, and then you would have the specific antibody taking over, and they will allow variants to come through. Hence, you'll have the cell-mediated response. That's what causes all the cytokinemic response from, I think, the mast cells or whatever, whoever produced them. But what I'm saying is, this is what it is, and this is why the longer you have the infection and it reaches the cell mediation, that's where you have all the reactions from the immune system, all the thrombosis and all the difference. So, and even the data shows you the post-vaccinations as far as the elderly. So we should be careful, and so I agree with you with the fact sheet. Now, the fact that they're turning political isn't fair on the PM. The PM has nothing to do with this. All right, you spoke about the emergency powers, right? Mm-hmm. The emergency powers and what the PM is doing shows you that this is a global agenda. This is bigger than the PM. This is something that I don't see where they could be blaming the PM for turning the vaccination into a political strategy, but we must bring out the truth to the people. You see the information as far as the different vaccinations. Pfizer own studies from John Hopkins show where in the trials, patients were given half the dosage and then given the full dosage later, so they were given less fluid, and they had a better immune response than those who suffered the full dosage. You see the information coming out of Israel saying that over 200 people has contracted COVID post-vaccinations, and 69 of those are said to be already received a double dose. Now, there could be some explanations for that. Maybe some people were incubating the virus at the time. But the fact that Dr. Fauci said that the virus lodges in your nasal passage and it can be breathed in and breathed out, that means you still can transmit. So we know the vaccination might impede transmission, but it can't stop transmission because you have to understand transmission dynamics, which is ongoing. And the fact that they haven't done, you need time to study the fertility effects, the cytotoxic effect, and the cytogenic effects. So that sheep who talk, but they tired, and we call it a rumbling. Maybe I should call you every day, you know. Tell them if they just listen to what I say and go pick up a book and go look, then they'll have a better sense. But I don't even care what they think about me, you know. Just tell them to approach me, man. Have a good day.
Absolutely. Now, it would be nice if we could actually have a dialogue, 52, because you said a lot, and I let you say a lot, because I want to have a dialogue because you packed in a lot of stuff in there. So the first thing is, I didn't read the letter with the doctor, but I saw the video. So here's a couple of points, right? He's essentially, through all the medical jargon, calling for us to have natural herd immunity. Now, the attrition rate of that, I believe, after looking at it, and I'm no doctor, is too high, right? To risk that is too high. That's A. B, he's saying that if you vaccinate everybody, they won't be able to protect against the variants. Okay, fair enough. But if you don't vaccinate everybody, what the medical science has shown, what real-world experience has shown, is that the virus will mutate. So the more you let it spread, the more likelihood that it will mutate. Further to that, the AstraZeneca vaccine has not been shown to be very effective against the South African variant, but is shown to be still effective against the UK variant. Now, when you're talking about the global agenda and you're talking about Fauci and all the stuff like that, we can address that another time. Good afternoon. Welcome to the revolution.
Hey, good afternoon. Hi. How are you doing?
I'm well. How are you?
I'm good. Let me ask you this, Juan. You, as an essential worker, when it comes time for persons as yourself, will you be taking the vaccine when the competent authorities say, "Well, okay, the media, their time now, right?"
Mm-hmm.
Will you be a be taking it?
Well, that's a personal choice, but I'm considering it.
What is that, yes or no?
It means I'm considering it. What do you mean?
If it's what yes do you mean? You're not sure then?
Right, yes, exactly.
But you're not sure?
Right, yes.
Sound to me, though. I mean, from listening to you, and I don't mean nothing personal visits, right? Sound to me, though, you seem to be promoting it for persons to take it.
I have no problem with anyone taking it. Go take it. No problem. Talk
but
to your
you
doctor.
Have you're skeptical about taking it your own self.
My doctor, I saw him yesterday taking it. I plan to have a conversation with him hopefully this weekend, and he may be able to convince me to take it.
Yeah. Okay.
So I'm done. You make up your own mind, but I don't think when people see people are going, well, it's not safe, right? And I don't think that to be the case. So from all I've seen, so if you and your doctor say go take it, I'm not gonna go. Don't take that. That's gonna. I'm not gonna do that. So talk to your physician. You could access one at the local clinic. There's lots of great doctors out there. Crispin Gomez, Neil Barker. I mean, Dr. Pinto. They're all consultants with the public. Hospitals Authority, you talk to him and you take him. My doctor, Dr. Darius Bain at the Family Medical Center at Sandyport, I'm going to go talk to him. I saw him take it. And depending on what he say, I may take it. Now, I was planning on taking the AstraZeneca, the Johnson & Johnson vaccine when it was available anyway. Uh-huh. So that I will take.
So you're kind of waiting on that.
I'm waiting on that, yes.
Yeah. Okay.
All righty. Okay, bye. Thanks for calling. Good afternoon. Welcome to... Says oxygen ass 52. Am I a joke to you? Good afternoon. Welcome to the
Revolution. Good afternoon, McCartney.
How's it going?
I remember 40 years to this, almost to this day, this French doctor came on the national news around the world and says, Mr. Rock Hudson either died or dying of acquired immune deficiency. Isn't he cured for AIDS yet? No, right? But I guess this might cure AIDS, I guess, because they always said immune mistakes. That's why they got cure it. But I guess this corona might even cure AIDS. I hope so. Listen now. Warren, let's say you're in the neighbor next door, right? You watch the people bring the blocks, the cracker rock, the sign, cement, and you ask your neighbor, is he going to build? He say no. Minister say he campaigning, but he telling us, but S&P wrong, election next year May.
Right.
I mean, like, Is it that smart? Remember, to play with the truth, you must be smart. Either be dumb, or he just read that smart. And see that he can't tell the truth. He can't talk the truth. We ain't campaigning. Election done next year May.
He ain't say he ain't campaigning. He didn't say that.
Huh?
He ain't say he ain't campaigning because he couldn't campaign. He said election's not due till next year May.
But then who gonna sustain this? A year and 4 months.
The election's happening in a few months, my brother. Soon.
But why he cannot?
Right? He's just not gonna give it out. No prime minister ever has.
I don't see it like this. They campaigning and they say election next May. The country broke. I'm like, why you won't play with the truth? It's going now. We ain't gonna trust him.
I gotcha. Now let me say this. come on. It's Friday. You know what that means? I can have alcohol tonight. So, and tomorrow. I can eat whatever I want. Let me say this, all right? We know Minutes is just playing coy, right? However, I don't expect him to come out and say when the election's going to be. No one has ever done it who's prime minister. Not with any advance notice. You're not going to give your political opponents that kind of advantage. So my wife and I got married in 2012, April 28th, 2012. Okay. So my wife, several weeks before we got married, was on a news assignment with the prime minister. And she goes, Mr. Prime Minister, I'm getting married soon. And I would like to be able to go on honeymoon. I'm getting married at the end of April. I'd like to be able to go on honeymoon. But if the election is happening anywhere around there, right, after that, then I won't be able to go on honeymoon because I'll be required to work. Because you can't go on vacation in an election. You only sick you could be if an election's happening if you're in news. That's it. That's the only excuse you get. Baby, sick, dead, right? So those are the excuses you get to not cover the election, right? It's all hands on deck. And so she's like, so you could just tell me when the election is so I can know if I need to move my wedding date or keep my wedding date. And Ingram just looked at her and patted her on the shoulder and go, and walked off, bro. Right? So that ain't something they give up. So I'm looking at minutes and I'm going, man, come on. You know what I mean? I don't expect him to give up the date, but I know exactly what he's doing. Good afternoon. Welcome to the election, to the revolution.
Hey, what's up, Brian?
It ain't the election, yeah. How's it going, bro? It's good. Dwight, they watching you, buddy.
How are you?
They watching you, buddy.
I hope that's a woman watching me.
I don't know.
Well, I hope it's a woman. If it's a female, I love macaroni and pork chops.
There you go.
Brian, listen, okay, we get. I was talking to one of the guys I work with, your star, right? How many doses? They say they got 20,000 or 20-something?
They got 20, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay, and that requires, the requirements of that is two shots or two doses.
Two, right, yes.
Okay, so now let's look at it, Mr. McCartney. Mm-hmm. What if I decide and 20 more thousand persons in this country decide they want to take it right away?
You got to wait. You can't take it.
Okay,
right.
Now, what's the flip side of that? The 20,000 that they vaccinating now, the people who wants it, they still would have to wait because the first doses have to be administered twice.
Right. Well, they're doing it 10 weeks.
When would we ever get to some sort of resolution about when we're going to have enough vaccines, adequate vaccines that people can take? And mind me, I was a conspiracy theorist in this, and I still have my doubts.
Mm-hmm.
But if I see persons that I am close with, Mr. McCartney, I'm talking about family members, and I consider my extended family members doing it, and people I'm close with, I think after a while,
you might take it. Yeah.
I will take it, yeah. But I don't have no objections about no one taking it. But the problem is, if you only have 20,000 doses in the Bahamas, population is close to what, 400,000 people. I want to know when. Like, I think, when will you vaccinate everyone twice?
It's a legitimate question to it.
Because it's like maybe when the cow come back and jump from over the moon, or the dish run away with the spoon, maybe then.
It's a legitimate question. They're not going to be able to if they don't get it.
It's
here.
Impossible.
Now, we've had several delays, but they're estimating early April for the other, right, 53,000 more.
But, Vaughn, let me leave you with this one. What I want you to really ask, right, the relevant authority, well, I do ask some people, it's like asking the wall, right? But what I want you to ask is, where is this money, where is the vaccine that the government paid down on, and if they could get the money back in those same AstraZeneca that the United States have in storage that they're not using, if maybe they can obtain it or buy it from them.
Yeah, I think you're right.
As long as they buy it and they bring it through, to airport, the right thing.
Yeah, you're right. They don't bring it on the boat on right. All right. I bring it right.
Have a good weekend,
right.
Bro.
Thanks, buddy. No, and that's a legitimate question, right? And it's a question a lot of people are asking, and that's not a political question. They're saying, well, how are you going to vaccinate the population if you don't have the vaccine? At what rate are you going to vaccinate the population? X, Y, Z. It says, man, Juan, look here. I'm getting tired of these people complaining about this vaccine to kill. The argument that if you don't want to take it, then don't take it. I mean, this ain't putting no gun to anyone's head. I mean, y'all do what y'all want, right? I'm going to do what's best for me. Now, I don't have any overarching concerns about, like, I take it it's going to kill me, right? Because I know people who've taken it, and they're okay. And so the more people I see take it who I know and who I have confidence in, the more likely I would be to take AstraZeneca. I'm waiting particularly on Johnson & Johnson because I want to get vaccinated, right? I do. So I'm a person who takes a flu vaccine every year. So, and I'm fine, right? Ain't that never happened, right? I give it to my children every year, a flu vaccine. They're fine. So you can't really freak me out too tough about the flu vaccine, right? About the COVID-19 vaccine. It was developed rapidly, and people have legitimate concerns about it. I understand that. But I ain't, like, freaking out about it. It says, Juan, the color of my palms and my hands and fingers have changed color to dark after sanitizing with all these different sanitizers. Do you know if there's a remedy to bring the color back? I don't know, man. You sure that's what it is? Say good day, Juan. Minutes in the medical labs are making hundreds of thousands of dollars on those tests. He will never repeal that emergency order. Well, look, it can't be about making money, man. It got to be about, you know, the public good. This says the PLP thinks Peter Krieger deal is similar to a BPL deal. Will they sign a deal for them and their boys? No. Hold up now. Hold. I want you to hold your horses. You ain't going to reframe no Oban deal, buddy. You're going to have to wear that. All right? That was egregious. You ain't going to whitewash that or make or fade that away. You're going to have to own Oban. The FNM is going to have to own Oban. Now, just say, don't do that. Just say, my bad. I messed up. I shouldn't have done that. I ain't perfect. I make mistakes. Say that. Don't do that. All right? I was here. You ain't going to style me. Good afternoon. Welcome to the revolution.
Hey, brother.
Hey, how's it going?
Everything on the quiet?
Yeah, man. Straight up. What's up?
Top shape.
All right.
First matter first. With this vaccine, like in, coming up in the next election, if the Most High spare my life to vote, I'm only one vote. I'm going to be taking this vaccine. And I'm going to tell you, if you give me a second, why I'm going to take this vaccine.
Okay.
You see, humans live we may, but die we must. We know we're going to die. And so, I know if my state, see, I have to follow the law. If the law is saying it's mandatory, then it's mandatory for everyone. What is good for the goose will be good for the gander. If the man...
There's no mandatory vaccine.
And there is no... Exactly. No. That's my point. So, we... Mr. Prime Minister, please stay focused. Your people who you're feeding and have done a marvelous job, okay, taking care of some serious things. Bohemian people are a little hurting. Not a little hurting, but hurting, okay? But when we analyze what you're doing, required in a lot of aspects, the politics and the nonsense is another matter. And people are upset because they lose their money. You know how Bohemian people and their money go. At the end of the day, the majority of sensible thinking Bahamians in and out and around the world have, in somewhat strange way, welcomed, all right, including myself, welcomed a strong hand at the helm, but yet focus enough to not let the people starve. Like, in my humble opinion, and this is my opinion, like the former prime minister did. Okay? And
all right. The former prime minister let people starve. That makes no sense. All right. Okay. Now, let's see. You see how your boy Dion Folk... Give me a break on the calls there. Thanks. This says, you see how your boy Dion Folk sneak in election date over you on? Dion said election within 90 days at the end of the emergency order. Elections will be in August, September. Yeah, I mean, I was thinking May, but the rate at which they're going, I'm going to rethink it. I'm going to give you my rationale next week. I'm thinking summer now. It says, things bad, one everywhere. People selling stuff on the side of the road, even in neighborhoods. Minutes must stop the travel, health, visa, and curfew. I'm with you. It says, Jesus, this is a long thing. Okay, you had a personal experience. I can't get into that today. This is when the vaccines were first ready for distribution. I had heard that Canada in particular ordered and received more than they needed for their population, yet they're still awaiting an order of the AstraZeneca vaccine from the U.S. Did some of these G8 countries stockpile vaccines and had to discard some? Why are they still causing a limitation on supply? Boy, good question. I think there's some geopolitical trade issues going on with this vaccine that are creeping in because of naked greed by political forces influenced by business, particularly in Europe. Hey, Juan, some of these same people who are talking about making it political is exactly what they're doing. People have opinions and can make their own decisions. I agree, but your opinion should be founded in some sort of logic and rationale, yes? This says, more blacks and Hispanics are dying from COVID-19 than Caucasians, so don't get the vaccination then. And this is from a nurse who works on a COVID floor in a U.S. hospital. Yeah, that's just a fact. Juan, you heard how the Mexican president talked about the U.S. not helping them with vaccines, and the next day they released millions of doses of AstraZeneca from their stockpile to Mexico and Canada. Seems like we're the only neighbor that got left out, and we only need a few hundred thousand from them. You think we're talking to them? They can only want to be our partners in the war against drugs and not the war for drugs. I'm in agreement with you on that. The Mexican issue, I know why they do this, Canada and Mexico. They're trying to mix the two up because I understand exactly what's going on with the U.S. and Mexico. So there's an increase in unaccompanied minors and others, but mainly unaccompanied minors, crossing the Mexican border into the United States or attempting to cross the Mexican border into the United States. The Trump administration had a policy with Mexico where Mexico would allow these people who were not Mexicans to remain in Mexico while they actually applied for refugee status or asylum, because the rule used to be you could just cross and you get asylum. That still exists, but the word has gone out that, okay, Trump's gone, cross the border, more or less. I'm dumbing it down a bit. But the Biden administration is trying to get Mexico to do more in dealing with the migrants who come from all over South and Central America in terms of crossing the border. And the vaccine is being used as influence to do that. And so they're looking out for their political interests. However, if you do have millions of doses of AstraZeneca vaccine that you're not going to use and you apparently don't need, it would be great if you could just do us a solid and let us buy some from you. You ain't got to give it to us. We'll buy it. It says the survivability rate is way too high for COVID-19 to be taking experimental vaccines, which nobody knows the long-term effects of. Even for the most at-risk, if the pharmaceutical companies have so much faith in their vaccines, then why are they indemnified against lawsuits just in case it kills you? That's called a moral hazard, folks. I mean, I disagree with you, and I think it's not only dangerous, and I'm not dissing you, I'm just saying that you should think about what you said. It's not only dangerous to say that, but it's also super insensitive. We've had 180 people die from COVID-19. Many of those people, more than 180 people, many of those people contracted COVID-19 in medical facilities in this country. If they were vaccinated, they could have been saved. You know, speak for yourself on these issues. If you don't want to take it because that's how you feel, then fine. But you're saying this to people who may not know better, and that you're not at risk and someone else is, and they don't take it because they may hear you say this and be influenced by it. It's really a bad look. This says, I'm not an anti-vaxxer. That's the first thing I want people to know. I don't care who takes it. Minister Davis, Kamalafi, or others. I just have a problem with the speed it was produced in, with not enough data long-term or on its adverse effects on the body, for one. I've also been wise enough to just not listen to the mainstream on the scripted information that's being put out. There are two sides to a story. I'm curious as to why they're stifling the other data, research, and opinions of other doctors and scientists with the same or better qualifications. Who's stifling the data? The mainstream media? If you don't want to take it, that's fine with you, but I don't agree with you that any data is being stifled. You just heard 50. You can't stifle data nowadays, right? Now, you may not see data among main news sources, but your primary news sources are going to vet any data you give them, right? The same thing with the aragonite thing. Someone gave me this stuff to go, oh, it's sold for X amount and Y amount of money. I checked with the U.S. Bureau of Statistics, I check with the U.S. Department of Agriculture, I check with the Minerals Department, the Geological Survey. It doesn't exist. So if I can't vet your data and verify it, why would I put it out? That's not what any responsible person would do. So when you see data sometimes not making it to the mainstream media, it's because it's not verifiable. We gotta take a break. But if you don't want to take it, that's fine. We got a break. We'll be right back.
Express Delivery, the Uber for items, packages, and documents. It's the Bahamas' most efficient domestic delivery service. We pick up and deliver for businesses and individuals, and we're open from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. for deliveries anywhere in Nassau. TF Express Delivery, the Uber for items, packages, and documents. Call us today at 815-4628 or visit our website, tfxdelivery.com.
Think safety first. Get to know LA Impact Windows and Doors for the lowest and affordable quality hurricane impact windows and doors, garage doors, showers, shutters, casement and sliding windows and doors for residential and commercial business, installation, glass and roll-up shutter repairs, special discounts for contractors and senior citizens, easy layaway plans too. Feel safe with LA Impact Windows and Doors, located in the Southland Plaza, East Street South, just three doors north of the Teachers Credit Union offices. LA Impact Windows and Doors, impacting your view. Phone 322-3667.
You asked for it, and now it's here. Introducing the all-new plant-based Rebel Whopper only at Burger King Nassau. The new Rebel Whopper is everything you expect in a Whopper with a meatless plant-based patty that is flame-grilled to perfection with all the fixings you love on that famous sesame seed bun. Come try out the new Rebel Whopper with fries and a Pepsi and see if you can tell the difference. The Rebel Whopper is 100% Whopper, 0% beef, and only at Burger King Nassau, where taste is king.
At Bahamas Bus and Truck Company Limited, we provide vehicles known for quality and durability. From the iconic Jeep Wrangler to the award-winning Grand Cherokee, we've got your everyday driver covered. For larger tasks, our Ram 1500, Mitsubishi Fuso Canter Trucks, CMC Verica Vans, and Fuso Rosa Jitneys do way more than just deliver. We even carry a wide variety of pre-owned vehicles. To keep you going, our parts, service department, and body shop can accommodate our brands and others. Call us today at 322-1722 or email info@bahamasbus.com.
Always on the go? Missed the show? You can now listen to Guardian Radio talk shows anytime, anywhere on Spotify and YouTube by searching Guardian Radio 96.9 FM or by entering the name of your favorite show. You can also listen by logging on to guardiantalkradio.com and clicking on the podcast tab. Guardian Radio, continuing to provide you with fresh news and smart talk anywhere, anytime, all day.
Good afternoon, Bahamas. Welcome back to The Revolution here on Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. I'm Juan McCartney. We're talking vaccines for quite some time. So again, right, you do whatever you want. I would suggest you speak with your doctor. I have already previously stated weeks ago that I'm taking the Johnson & Johnson vaccine as soon as it becomes available. What is happening now, which the government is doing a better job of, but should do a more robust job of, is that they're showing people taking the vaccine, and it's persuading people to take it because it's not a mandatory vaccine. And I won't lie to you. You show me someone I really trust, like Dwayne Sands or Darius Bain, and it makes me think more deeply about taking AstraZeneca. I will say that, right? I'm not one of these people who can't be persuaded otherwise. Well, some stuff like your emergency order, but it's helping persuade people. And I think if your doctor says that you're fine taking the vaccine, you should certainly take it. I don't want any more calls. Thanks, though. So this says, yes, I just got my vaccine along with 100 white people and 3 black people. Wow, did I miss the memo? Well, they had the meeting and they... No, I'm playing. This says, it is ridiculous to subject us to Anton. Anton didn't call. What are you talking about? Did Anton call and I blacked out? Did I not realize? Did I pass out? Juan, we already have herd immunity. We may have herd immunity now. You might be right. All right. You might be right. You might be right, but not. We'll be forced to take this vaccine every year. I think this vaccine is as necessary as the flu vaccine. Juan, keep in mind, it only protects you from known variants, just like your immune system. Yeah. I take the flu vaccine every year. So I, you know, you got to bring me along on the COVID vaccine, but hey, like, oh, vaccines. And I give my children the flu vaccine every year. right? So I wouldn't give my children something if I dreamed it would harm them, all right? Me, I'll do it if there's a chance. If I imagine that something would harm my children, I wouldn't give it to them. Now, you do what you want with your children. All right? They're yours. You do what you want with your body. But I'm here to tell you, the flu vaccine is perfectly safe to give to children. Tough 52, stop coming on this radio acting tough. Like he threatening people. He's a little boy. His mother's writing a check. His body can't cash. Why did he be having this beef? Why are we having this talk show beef? The talk show texters and callers beef. This is, hey, well, I'm trying to ingest what 52 has to say. It's like trying to read the entire Bible in under 5 minutes. Jeez. It's a lot to unpack. I ain't going to lie. It says, afternoon, Juan, one reason we shouldn't vote FM and PLP, they both supposed to have a fixed date for elections. You're right. They do. Says, Juan, that Freudian slip made my day. Good timing about the election. Says, the citizen should just be prepared to question the campaigners, Juan. Where's the FOIA? Why no fixed election date? Term limits? Campaign finance reform? And ask about local issues in their constituency? Don't smile in their face and ask them what the deal is. Boy, that's Bahamans for you, boy. It cuss you right out when you aim down. And you go, oh, PM! Oh, Mr. Davis, when you leave, PR cussing. Good day, one. The PM would look like he totally lied if he called an early election after Brave Davis called him out and saying that he told Moody's or Standard & Poor's of an early election. You notice his language is very careful. This is 1 minute to 1.5 minutes is enough time for your friend 52 to make his point. Everybody knows that he's smart. He needs to get to the point as quick as possible. I agreed. He could be more succinct. They said, did you listen to the audio with Kirk Franklin using profanity? We still love him. It shows that no one's perfect. We must pray for strength from God every day. Kirk Franklin, I haven't heard the audio. I ain't got a problem with you, cousin. Some of these videos y'all send to these religious people are a bit rich for me. A bit rich for my blood. This says, so if the law says do it, don't question, just nod and say yes, sir, right away, sir. It is in. What law? What do you mean? Hey, Juan, you know our people are sad with timing and schedules. I have very little faith the next door will be administered in time. Even worse is they use up all of this shipment. A lot of this first shot will go down the drain if timing is essential. Yeah, they're going to have to time it properly. Juan, Bahamas need to remember that the opposition also exists to challenge the ruling governance. If you want the best out of your country, feedback should be taken and considered from all sides. We're all Bahamians. Well, see, the thing is this. That you criticize a process of rolling out a vaccine, that ain't making nothing political. If I don't feel as though you're doing it effectively and I'm an opposing political party, I'm going to say I don't feel you're doing it effectively. That's it. That ain't making it political. I, your political opponent, don't feel you're doing it properly. Not because I'm your political opponent, but I don't feel you're doing it properly. All right? I don't have no political party, and I feel that the vaccine rollout can be done differently and with an inclusion of the private sector with more options of vaccines. All right? So that I ain't making it political. That's just a simple observation and critique. And if you can't take that, you best check out of the human race. You certainly shouldn't be in governance. I want, do you think there's a PLP vaccine and an FNM one? Do you think an FNM would trust Anton to jab their arm? Okay. McCartney, our beloved America, is like a jealous show-off, pushy lover. Just hint, hint that we're going to get it from China. Then watch him. Watch how fast America will come running with the vaccines to sideline its rival China. We don't necessarily have to buy any vaccine from America. Just negotiate better. You know what? They make a good point. It says, I, too, believe that we've achieved herd immunity. It's interesting to hear others with the same opinion. I haven't ruled that out. I won't lie to you. I have not ruled that out. The numbers at which people are contracting COVID-19, so they tell me, the numbers you're reporting, suggest to me that we have very little community spread and quite a lot of community activity. It says, I personally think the vaccine is safe, and I believe this vaccine push is just designed to walk this COVID fiasco back. They can't just say COVID wasn't as dangerous as we thought. That's an interesting point of view, actually. Won't lie to you. They said, don't send anyone on my porch to campaign who's still paying rent. Okay. It says, the curfew must be lifted up to 12 midnight to avoid accidents and speeding on our streets. We're in a city with over 250 people. These leaders seem to be demonically influenced. City over 250,000. Oh, Lord. All right. As Texter says, these lying parties, we should be gone from our country. Both PLP and FNM, they lied to us so far. They lied to us for far too long. A new group would be better and different. It says, Juan, watch all the white Bahamians intelligently get the COVID vaccine while the black Bahamians sit there thinking it's a conspiracy and get sicker. Now, look, that's fine. There may be a lot of white Bahamians. I ain't been there. I ain't checked, right? But I've heard white Bahamians say they don't trust the vaccine. I've heard numerous white Bahamians saying that the vaccine's a plot to, like, track us, kill us, the mark of the beast. So don't act like it's just the black people, all right? Now, it may be a different thing in terms of the ratio in Bahamians. But when you hear people whiling, if you look at America, it's the white people are whiling, dude. A lot of them are like, hey, you know what I mean? So a lot of them are taking it. They're not a monolith, is what I'm trying to say. All right. Look, this has been interesting. We're going to be back, God Spare Life, on Monday. I got a few more texts. I'll try to read them here. But the message I want to send to you is, I believe you should make your own personal choices in terms of your health. However, I believe you should make informed choices. If you choose not to take a vaccine, fine. But for your own good, it should be an informed choice. Speak to your physician. Speak to people you trust, who you know are informed, scholarly people. Seek out information from credible sources online and make the best informed decision you can make. I never told y'all to go take no vaccine, even though I said I'm taking the Johnson & Johnson vaccine when I can get it. I had no intention of taking AstraZeneca, primarily because I don't want to take two doses of it. We do not know the long-term effects of the vaccine. The vaccines work. All science says so. Yes, there are two sides to every story, but there can only be one set of facts. So look at your options and make the best informed decision you can make. I've already made my decision on Johnson & Johnson. I am more likely to be convinced on taking AstraZeneca after I've seen people I trust take it, and I'm going to speak with those people. I intend to, if he has time, to speak with Dr. Dwayne Sands, and hopefully he can speak with us on this program, but I'm sure he'll be on other programs. I'm going to go speak with Dr. Darius Bain, and I'm going to go make a decision. I'm going to speak with Dr. Marcus Cooper. All right? I trust them. I know them. And I'm going to have them help guide my decision. Okay? I suggest you do the same with people you trust. You do as you want, but it's always best to be informed when making a major decision about your health. All right, I'll read a couple more of these and we gotta go. Juan, the issue some of us have with those of you who get the vaccine is that in a few weeks or a couple of months, you guys in the media and politicians and so-called doctors will tell us who haven't gotten the vaccine that we can't attend church or go to Atlantis or Bahama or go to school, etc., because we haven't gotten the vaccine, and we will harm Juan McCartney and his family and her Grammy and others who got the vaccine. You can't harm me if I vaccinated. You need to worry about you. You got me. I'm when Johnson & Johnson come, where's July, June? I can all out. Right? I'm getting it. I'm good. Right? The children, I'm not so worried about because they don't get the COVID like that. But you need to worry about you. Don't worry about harming me. McCartney, considering a fire uptown somewhere off East Street, did you all send any reporters to investigate? A fire somewhere off East Street? Where off East Street? East Street's a long, long street. Bahamians don't trust the two parties. They all must go. RIP for them. Go home, PLP and FNM. 50 years of lies is enough. Okay. Why is Ed Fields the spokesperson for the government while the government has a whole COVID team to talk to? I think Ed's the co-chair of the vaccine committee or the deputy chair or something like that. Ed Fields. Ed on every committee. Ed on. I clown him about that sometimes. All right. That's going to do it for the show today. You guys have a great weekend. We'll be back Monday, Lord willing. Take care out there and have a great day, Bahamas.
The Revolution with Juan McCartney is brought to you in part by Burger King, Fidelity Bank, TF Express Delivery, Lawrence Electric Motors, Commonwealth Bank, Bahamas Bus and Truck Company Limited, J.S. Johnson, Wendy's, and LA Impact Windows and Doors.